Hi everyone, welcome again. It's that time of the day again where we meet. So for those of you who are back, great you're back. For those of you who are new, very welcome. Today I'd like to remind you a little bit about to keep yourself healthy during this time. So just very important, just to keep your, and the way you keep your body as healthy as possible so it can deal with whatever comes the body's way is by, of course, staying really relaxed. That is the main thing, especially if you start to feel under the weather. Doesn't matter what the reason is you feel under the weather. When the nervous system is relaxed enough, it has the resources to get on top of it. So sleep is so important. So sleep a lot, stay relaxed, do the points that we've been talking about all this time. As soon as you notice the tension is building up in your body, relax your eyes, behind your eyes, the jaw, the root of the tongue. I've seen some remarks about the root of the tongue, and it's a nice inquiry. So if you focus, I mean, the root of the tongue can literally there where you feel the tongue more or less starting in the throat, or just the back of the tongue, and maybe it goes much deeper. It's your inquiry. It's wherever you feel that is. Just relax this area and see what happens, yeah? Just sort of be with that and be explorative. You don't need to know exactly. That's actually quite perfect. If you go a little bit into the unknown, it takes you out of your head. So talking about relaxing yourself, sleeping a lot, and staying positive. So staying positive is through doing yoga or meditation. Do something that you've wanted to do all that time. Stay away from the tech. A little bit, at least. Don't overdo it, especially not in the evenings. Do something old-fashioned in the evenings, like reading a book or watching a movie. Try not to have the Wi-Fi on all day around you or the phone close to your head too much. Leave it out a little bit so you give yourself a break from it. And then I'd like to broach a little bit the subject about what we... I mean, Bas found this Facebook post. My husband found this Facebook post that said something like... this situation, it looks like the universe sends us all to our rooms to think about our lives or what we've done with our lives. And yeah, it feels a little bit like that, doesn't it? We're all kind of sent home and sent to our rooms to reflect. So my hope is that you do that, that you do reflect and not just try and distract yourself with all sorts of things. And the reflection could be about what would you change in your life when we go back, when this is all over? What would you, what have you learned? And that would be a really nice thing to share with each other. So that could be the question where we comment under the video after this is over, because it takes a moment maybe to think about it. And it could be that you know now two things. It might be that you want to think about it a bit more, come back later. I'll remind you at the end of the session again. But I think it's a really important question. I've thought about it for the last couple of days a bit, like what am I noticing in myself and what would I like to change? Like slowly but surely, the system settles in a different rhythm and I like it. And there's a couple of things like that. So for yourself, or if you could be relaxed in this situation and it would give you something, what would you change when this is over? So anyway, it's a good question to think about. All right, so for the movement part, it's going to be quite mundane. We're going to work on the core and the butt. So with the idea that lots of us sit a lot. I know my team anyway, they're sitting a lot at home. So there's the whole idea of getting to the office and back is not there anymore. So you do use your body a lot less. And the butt especially can get lazy, which can also make your lower back unstable or your hips unstable. And I saw a little bit of comments around lower back pain and things like that. So this is really helpful if you repeat this every day. So of course we keep it short. So it is something you can repeat every day and you can really help, feel it will help to ground you, but also to stabilize the whole midsection of the body. So let's get going. If you don't have something soft to lie on, you may want to get it. A yoga mat, of course, is ideal, but even a folded blanket will help to make this easier for yourself. And we'll do a little bit of lying down and then a little bit of lunges and work around the buttocks. So we'll start lying down. And you can lie on your back. And the hip points, the points of the hips that are sticking forward, you can bring them towards each other. And of course, we end with the meditation as well. Eh? So we're not just doing button core for the rest of the time. That'll kill the button core. So bring the hip points together and then lift the knees more or less over the hips and press the lower back down. So the navel moves towards the spine. So it doesn't have to be fully in the floor, but it needs to go down as well. Lower legs parallel with the floor, arms next to the body, pressing the lower back down and trying to lift the sacrum off the floor. Whether the sacrum actually lifts or not is not so important. It's the trying it that will make the muscles work, and we'll do five. So exhale, lift. It's not easy, it won't come up. I mean, you can of course rock up. That's not the same. You try and do it without the momentum. So you saw that? So excellent. Let's do five. Exhale, lift, inhale down. So try and get your knees up as much as possible. Yeah. Okay, we can do another five, I think. Keep going. Till you feel a bit of a burn. It starts to happen for me now. And then you can place your hands behind your head. And we use the upper body. So front ribs in. Take your elbows up a bit and then exhale. Lift elbows to the ceiling and inhale back down. Exhale, elbows to the ceiling, inhale back down. So you lift your upper body and shoulder blades off the floor. Don't pull on the head. Make this work from the abdominals. Exhale, lifting. Wonderful. Three more. Two. Okay, and take a moment here, feet to the floor. Take a deep breath in. And out. Wonderful. Then we'll do a little cross, so you can bring your hands behind the head again, and the knees over the hips, and you're now going to extend your left leg, left elbow towards right knee. Don't bring the knee to the elbow, so it's just trying to get there. Inhale, knee back, and come back to center, and exhale, right elbow towards the left knee. Right leg extends, and back. Keep going. Opposite elbow to knee, knee stays over hip. It's just the upper body that moves towards the opposite knee. Okay, keep going. I already did this a few times before this video, so I'm taking a break. Otherwise, I can't laugh anymore tomorrow, but keep going at home. A few more. Keep going. And I want you to keep going till you feel that's enough, and then you can join me in chilling out. Wonderful. Inhale and release if you haven't released yet. Okay, and then rock up to all fours. Just move your hips around for a moment. Inhale, open the chest, lengthen the front of your body. Come into your back bend, your cow pose, and exhale, cat pose. Lengthen the back body. Two more. Come back to neutral, place your hands further forward, fingers nice and wide, tuck your toes. Exhaling, downward dog. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, step your right foot to your right hand, back knee to the floor. Keep your back toes tucked, inhale, take your arms up. And exhale, just for one moment, slide the shoulder blades down to bring a little bit of relaxation in the upper body. Inhale, take your arms up again, and now we work on the lower body, the buttocks. What you're going to do is press your left ball of the foot down, take the left heel back, and with that movement, you take your left knee up. So there we go. So maybe Louise wants to join us, who is filming us. I'm trying to get her to join us. All right, there we go. Press the heel back and press into the ball of the left foot. Take that knee off the floor and down. We do four more. Lift and down. If this is too much with the hands, you can bring your hands in front of the chest. And down, two more, and down, fun, huh? Let's go up one more time. This time, inhale, take your arms up. Squeeze your buttocks here, exhaling, folding the upper body over the front leg. Take your arms back. Press into the right heel now to take your body back up. Two more. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale forward. Inhale up. Exhale, knee down. Okay. One last one. My buttocks are definitely already feeling it. Take your arms down. And now with your toes untucked, you're going to press into the front of the foot and take that back knee up. There we go. Lift and down. Both buttocks are working. Lift and down. Press into the front of the foot. Lift and down. Hands down. Downward dog. Move around here a little bit to loosen out your butt. So you move your butt from left to right. And then other side. Inhale, left leg rises. Exhale, step through, back knee to the floor. Inhale, arms up. Exhale. Now press the back of the heel, the back heel back, and press into the front of the ball of the foot. Take the knee up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down and up. Stay here. Exhale, front body hovers over the front leg, take the arms back. Press really strongly to the left heel as you take your arms back up, upper body up. Two more. Exhale, folding. Inhale, up. Exhale, folding. I think this is three more. Inhale, up. Exhale, back knee down. Wonderful. Hands down. Toes untucked, if that's possible. Don't worry if it's not. Just do this again with your toes tucked. And then press into the top of the foot. Squeeze both buttocks a bit and lift the knee up and down. Up and down. Up and down. One more time. Up and down. Hands down. Back to downward dog. And move. Inhale here, press into your hands, take your hips up and back, and exhale, knees to the floor, and come and sit upright for a moment, allowing your body to settle. Relaxing the jaw. Okay, and then you can come and get yourself ready for your meditation. Phew. So it's short, but very beneficial. And if you want more, I don't think the suggested class is this class, but there's suggested class underneath, of course, but there's also a class that's called Core, Butt, and So Much More, something like that. And this is a little snippet of that, and there's much more for your body just to help stabilize it. So it's fun to do it. Okay, so find your seat, either on a chair or support yourself leaning against something, but then perhaps with something in your lower back so you do have the arch. If you're sitting on the floor, make sure you've got enough height underneath your hips so that perhaps your knees are a little lower than the hips. That helps. And then, whenever you're ready, close your eyes. And I'll give you a moment to settle just by yourself. Feeling how the body, when you leave it alone, the breath calms down, the heart calms down. And after the work we've just done, you may even feel that your seat is steadier than normal. I feel it. Now release any tension. Take a deep breath in. And a long breath out. Inhale deep. Exhale out through the pubic bone. Sink the energy. One more deep breath like that. Exhaling, sink the energy. Wonderful. Now just for a moment, bring your attention to your eyes. Relax the eyes. Behind your eyes, still deep within the brain. Relax your jaw, the mouth, and the root of the tongue. Relaxing deep within the throat. Feel your heart for a moment, relax, soften. And then relax around your waist and belly. And feel gravity. Let gravity have you. Relax the flesh, the skin of the bones. And let your skeletal system hold you upright. Relax through the bones as well. Any tension you may feel, release. And steady yourself on the earth, underneath you. The floor and somewhere underneath that, the earth. And again, you can place your fingertips on the floor to help you with that if needed. Feel that support underneath you, that solidity, that stability. And let that help you to ground your energy, your body. And let's go through the points quickly one more time. Relax your eyes. Behind your eyes. Relax the root of the tongue. Feel how both of those points pull your head back a bit. Back in line with the spine. Relax around the waist and belly. And let gravity have you. Feel the apana, the downward flow of energy. And then tune into the field of your body, the whole field of your body. And notice how you feel physically. If there's any tension you're holding, any tightness. Or perhaps you feel only relaxation and groundedness. But whatever it is you feel, give it space. Give it the space so it can even increase a bit. Also the tension, so it can fully show itself. and you get a sense what you're holding. You can only release and let go of something once you're aware of it. So allow your body to speak to you, to communicate with you, and listen. When you are aware, and when you allow it to be, and when you welcome it, you're not trying to make it go away anymore or ignore it. The body softens as a result a bit. Be aware of the space around the body that is always loving and supportive. That still space that's always there. Spacious awareness that's timeless. Surrounding all that which changes. Be aware of both the physical sensations and that change all the time, and the space around it that's unchangeable and timeless and always there. And know your heart is loving awareness, your mind is, and it can hold that. It can hold whatever it is you feel. And you can also say thank you to your body for, like we did yesterday, thank you for holding me. Thank you for protecting me, because it's trying to protect you by carrying that tension, unconsciously trying to protect you from something. So thank you, body, for doing that. But I'm okay right now. And let go a bit more. So stay with being with the body a bit longer. And notice when you show gratitude to the body, when you understand what it's doing, how the body softens. And then tune into your heart. And take a moment to feel what lives inside your heart. It could be that you feel love. It can also be that you feel a particular emotion that you've been trying not to feel, like sadness or insecurity or vulnerability. Here too, just know your heart can hold it with loving awareness. And the space around your heart, the space around the body that's unchangeable and timeless, holds it with love. Give a moment of space for that emotion to be there. When we all meditate, there's a lot of love around to hold for all of us. aware of the sensations in your heart and the feelings, but also that stable, loving space around the body that holds it all, in which it all arises and passes away, knowing that emotions or feelings are never, they never stay, they come and go. But that space around them, the loving awareness in which it all arises, is ever present. Right there for you to lean into, to rest into. And then you can say thank you to your heart, to that part of you that holds emotions and tries to protect you through that. So thank you. 3 times you can say the words thank you to yourself. And notice you're all right in this moment, right now. And then tune into your mind and notice what lives there. Is it quiet, or are there lots of thoughts jumbling around, one on top of the other? Hard to keep track? Or has it all calmed down for a moment? And give it space, leave it alone, just let it be. Knowing what you notice in your mind, they're just clouds in a bright, clear, vast sky. And when you leave the clouds alone, you just allow them to be, but you leave them alone, the sky is also there, and you can feel the brightness and the clarity and the vastness of the sky. The space that which holds the clouds, that space that is unchangeable, always there, ever present, and lovingly holding and being the space for the clouds. And notice that those clouds, the thoughts that jumble and the busyness in your mind and the monkey mind, too, is a protection mechanism of your system, a survival mechanism. So thank yourself for that. Thank your mind for doing that. Even though you may not need it, it's just trying to protect you. But it's helpful if you can notice deep down, deep inside yourself, that you don't need it. And that it's okay to be quiet and still within. And to be able to relax. And relax. Tune back into your heart. And feel loving kindness for yourself. Feel compassion for yourself, for your body, for your mind, for your heart, that works so hard to protect you. But also maybe see that not all of that is necessary or even helpful at times. And that it's okay for those areas to relax. So that all of you can be more present in the reality of this moment. And if you're in a situation that you can meditate, your present moment is pretty okay, I think. So be grateful if that's something you can feel right now. One more time, three times, say thank you to your body, to your mind, to your heart, and to each other for showing up every day and doing this together. And feel the wish to be at peace, to be peaceful, and to accept life as it is. The wish to be able to relax deeply and enjoy the simplicity, the simple moments of life. And remember, peace is an inside job. It really, really is. It's not dependent on the outside, not hardly as much as you think. When you find peace inside, you see it around you. You can see it in a table, in a chair, in the carpet. You can see it in anything and everything once you see it inside. So may you all be peaceful, happy, and free of suffering. And extend this wish to be happy and peaceful and free of suffering to all beings, to all of us together, and all beings everywhere without exception. May all beings be peaceful, happy, and free from suffering. May all beings be happy. And rest in the knowledge that love, that loving awareness is always there in the background. And you can tune into it anytime. And if you don't feel it, it's just stuff in the way. It doesn't mean it's not there. Knowing it's there is helpful. And all you need to do to access it is to relax deeply enough to feel it. So it becomes a felt sense. So may you all be able to access the light within. Okay. From your heart, feel your whole body with gentleness. Feel your head again, relaxing behind your eyes. Feel your jaw again, relaxing your jaw, your root of the tongue. Feel the waist and the belly again, relax. And feel the pull of gravity again, the earth having you, supporting you. Feel your whole body, and then as you're inhaling next, while you move your fingers a little bit, you can blink your eyes open and give yourself a bit of a stretch. And a hug. Okay. So I hope this whole half hour has grounded you. The energy has sunk down out of your head into your body. And think about the question, what would you change when this is all over? What would you like to change in your life? How would you like your life to be different? And I'd love to get some ideas underneath the video. When this video stops, you can leave the comments of that question perhaps under the actual YouTube video so we can all access and look at it and inspire each other of the changes that we think would be a really good idea. Maybe for yourself personally, I think that's the most interesting thing to think about, but also broader, like humanity and life in general. Okay, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll be back tomorrow.